downloadable content? Wow. Yes, I will say I love this game. I love it. But yes, the enemy stats go up fast. Anyway, welcome. So a Digimon game came out today. Not this one. So Digimon Survive came out today, but I got it. I will be playing it in my own time because I don't want to just play it once a week. So kind of in celebration of a new Digimon game coming out, and I'm very excited about how it's going to be, I'm streaming another Digimon game. So I've streamed Cyber Sleuth, Digimon Story Cyber Sleuth. And that is kind of one style of Digimon game. Kind of more like... say like Dragon Warrior Monster style, maybe like more Pokemon-y style, but where you like more standard RPG. This is Digimon World, and Digimon World games are all about taking a baby, raising them up, having them die, getting a new baby, and raising that one. So Digimon World 1 is one of my favorite games of all time. I love 1. Then after 1 in the same style was redigitized. That never came out in English, but there was a fan translation patch for the PSP, which I did have, and I did play, and I really liked that one. Then I believe 2016-17, Digimon World Next Order came out, and I love it. I put 150 hours into it to platinum it. I really love the Digimon World style of game, so let's jump in. Okay, so difficulty, play on easy. The only difference, I mean, there's a few differences, but normal is what I would call hard mode. It's grindier mostly. You get less stats from training and battling. Enemies have higher stats. Do more damage. Frankly, it's just grindier. You just have to spend more time raising Digimon. Play on easy. I'm gonna play on easy. There's no reason not to play it on easy. Honestly. Yes, Digimon, digital monsters. Digimon are the champions. I love Digimon. Alright, so yeah, I've always just played it on easy. Normal is just more of a grind. Normal hard, it's just more numbers. It really is like, in this game you raise Digimon and you train them. You get fewer stats in training on normal mode. So it really means, because this game is a cycle where you raise a Digimon, you raise it up in stats, and then it dies. You raise a new one, that new one tends to inherit stats. You've got techniques, you've got better facilities, it'll go a bit higher up in stats. And so it basically cycles. This just means you have to go through way more cycles to advance in the game. Easy's more fun. Play it on easy. Do not play it on normal. It's less fun. This is Digimon Rancher, yes. I mean, the thing is, Digimon is based on Tamagotchi, so this Digimon world are more about its roots. I will be playing Shiki. I pretty much always play a girl when I have the choice. It makes very little difference in this one. The translation isn't amazing. I don't think it's like Cyber Sleuth where you accidentally play as a disaster lesbian. If you pick girl, because they base it around the guy. But might as well go for the girl. And give her a name. Alright, how do I name myself? Yeah, his goggles man is huge. All of the male characters have dumb goggles in Digimon. I'm gonna go very boring for me, but we do get to name our partners, so if you want to name a Digimon, there is a name button. Yeah, Cyber Sleuth's translation was amazing because, I mean, if you saw me stream Cyber Sleuth, she was absolutely a disaster lesbian, completely utterly by accident because of the translation. I hope I haven't lost it. We do have goggles as the girl, by the way. There they are. And as always in a Digimon World game, we get isekai'd.
What happened?
So that was a Digivice, a very old school Digivice. They were like rectangular, just blocks where you'd like raise your Tamagotchi Digimon. Oh, lads! That's my lads! So yes, we can have a look at us. So yeah, we do have goggles around our neck for some reason. And I believe that's our Digivice in our pouch. And we've got a smartwatch now. Oh, this game's in English. Next order's in English. You might be thinking of Redigitize, which did not come out in English. So I played a brief hint of one, but if you've played any Digimon World game before, you know that Machindermon's showing up. Big staple of the Digimon World games. They pronounce him really weirdly. I'm not gonna call him Machine Draymon, I think they go with. I'm not gonna be saying that. That's Machine Draymon. Fight, fight, okay? Fight!
Get back! We can take it from here!
Lads!
You just need to give us commands as usual.
What is it? You've always given us commands in battle.
Have I?
You seem really confused all of a
sudden. You see, it's like you were dragged into this world.
It can't be helped. We'll back you up.
You've got to be kidding me. You're not supposed to forget us. You're partners.
They English voiced this game, yes. It's not fully voiced, but cutscenes are. Alright, so we're gonna get our intro into fighting. We can use orders. So yes, we are not directly controlling our Digimon. Okay, so the order ring. So, this game has two, you're doing two Digimon at once. So you've got order rings for either, and you can open up L1, L, and R1. Alright, large at the bottom, so time until the ring closes. Yes, they have limited time to give the order, but they will do it on their own. They will fight on their own, but you can basically tell them to do certain things. Fight!
come.
Here I come. All right, agitation. Okay, go on X. So yeah, there's a middle thing.
No holding back.
These all cost points. Each partner has a point, so if I ever get a chance to look at the bottom right, you'll see there's a number above each Digimon, and that is kind of their, like, order points. More order power! So, you basically cheer on your Digimon through a fight to get, points, to spend points. Alright, support to gain. And if you do it with good timing, you get more points. If you do it when they're starting an attack or guarding an attack, I believe. Yeah, when a partner attack is hit and after taking damage. Yeah, there you go.
Stay calm.
So you're gonna hear a lot of voices.
Here I come.
Next one. Get up.
It is quite chaotic, and yes, these voice lines are kind of burned into Vicus's soul. Spend restored order power using War Greymon's special move.
You got it.
I think he's guarding, so he'll do it. Yeah. So when they're doing an action, you have to wait until after the action has happened. Here we go. Yeah, there is one voice line we use constantly from this game, which is very funny. You can see we're struggling though. His health bar was not going down much,
so,
and ours is going down pretty hard.
No good?
No. I have to keep going. I finally met my tamer. But this is where I'm a goner?
Absolutely not.
We may be defeated here.
Yes, that is War Greymon's shield on his back, yes. Ho ho ho, our Digivice is glowing.
The light of a bond?
I can feel the power. The bond is transforming into power.
Let's go. As long as you're with us,
we can still fight.
Our outfit is very silly, but. All right, so yes, you get special moves by pressing them both at the same time. So yeah, there are skills, like, there's basically two things. The Digifuse skill is basically a mega attack if you have 150 points in both of them. If you have certain Digimon, EXE is available. And we'll see what that is in a moment. If you know the series, you probably know what's coming.
Yes.
EXE fun is amazing. I love it. Hey, it's Omegamon or Omnimon. So yes, if you have two Digimon that can DNA Digivolve, you can DNA Digivolve them in a fight. Success! We will not see EXE for a very long time after this. This is the opening theme. And it will show up a lot. I like this song a lot. But yeah, we got our ass handed to us. Oops.
Isn't the time to be sleeping! We must defend our partner!
I believe the music changes when you DNA Digivolve, yes. Yeah, we still got Rex. That is Machine Dramon.
I go. That's it.
That might be Kirk Thornton. But I'm not gonna lie, I love that it opens as powerful as this. It's a great opening to the game. Like, it's so classic. War Greymon and Metal Garurumon's signature moves. Omnimon. Mwah. Oh, who doesn't love the English Digimon movie? It's perfect. So this game is pretty much a direct sequel to 1, by the way. You don't need to have played Digimon World 1 to play this game.
You're all right.
But a lot of the plot points are from it. Machine Dramon's turned into a Tokemon there, I believe. Digimon Mal Digivolving into Machine Dramon, it came from 1. I can't remember if Redigitize is also... I think Redigitize is probably the sequel to 1, and then this is a sequel to Redigitize, but...
Don't
we do get some dialogue
us.
Options. Like We're Cyber Sleuth, there's some times where it's not really an option, it's just a full dialogue, but they make you click through it. Yes, pretty much. The choices are not really choices, yes. Digimon! My old friend! Hi. Just laying on the ground. Just having a nap.
A human? A machine Draymon disappears and a human appears. You're fascinating.
Yeah, they call it Machine Draymon. I can't. It's Machine Draymon. It's fine. It literally only bothers me.
The machine Draymon should have been.
Don't worry about my outfit. It's extremely weird.
But...
it's perhaps not the weirdest outfit in the game, though. Yeah, machine Draymon.
You defeated that machine Draymon. That must be what destabilized.
They say it
the
so often.
Dimension.
It's like names on the chalkboard every time, guys.
These must be your partners.
So you
then
actually up the ante.
That's an odd relation.
We up the ante in this one by giving you 2 partners.
They did everything they could to defend you.
My friends.
No need to look so depressed.
They're dead, Gigimon. Don't be mean.
They were partner Digimon, so it is possible to revive them with a Digi-Egg. I have preserved them in external storage.
It's a thing in Digimon that Digimon in the digital world don't die. They are always reborn as eggs. So, that was in the original show.
Hold your partner in your heart and hope
for the best. All right. So, yes, at this point in the game, I don't get any bonuses. So we can look at some Digivolution details. So we have a lot of eggs to choose from. There are a lot of Digimon in this game. I don't believe quite as many as Cyber Sleuth, but a lot. There are a lot. So I have already chosen what eggs I'm gonna go for first. Which one makes the bunny? This one. And it is one of the ones I'm picking. Not actually this bunny. I'm not actually getting this bunny right here. But I am getting his friend, Lopmon. Terriermon is a little difficult to get on your first one. Which is this one, by the way. This one makes Terriermon. Pretty much every egg goes to 4 or 5 rookies, so you never get trapped. My aim My aim is Lopmon, the brown bunny. You can get your own machine Digimon. It might be locked initially. There are some Digivolutions that are locked until you do them in the story. Machine Digimon might be one. I'm pretty sure you can. As I said, I'm aiming for Lopmon, but I might not get Lopmon. I'll explain why. Anyway, I'm gonna go with this egg. So this starts with Kodomon, which leads to Kokomon. Which is the one that goes to Lopmon in the show. They can't give an... Babies go to several different rookies because they can't have a baby for each rookie. There's like 30 rookies. It may be a stat issue. I'll get into it once I select my egg. I decided on this Digi egg. That's a baby right there. Alright, oh, I get to name. Anyone want to name my bunny? This is not Gun Bunny. Gun Bunny is Terriermon over here. This is the other bunny. Aw, Mocha's an X. Great, that's first name pick is amazing. I also get to name my other one. So, my other one is going to be Gomamon, who I have on camera. My Gomamon. I don't have a Lopmon plush, so I went for Terriermon, but I'm aiming for Gomamon, my fish boy. And here we leave is this one. Ichimon to Bukamon, who then goes to Gomamon. All right, who wants to name my lad? I've decided on this Digi egg. That's very good. I don't actually know if there are many mice. Digimon in general. Yes, Goemon was very cruelly excluded from Digimon World 1. That has since been rectified and he's been in every game since. That's Goomy right there, absolutely. Alright, first trophy get. The babies.
This is a tremendous success.
Sure is.
Then their rebirths will be complete. Just remember.
You should have called Pikachu Mon, yeah.
You have a duty to care for them.
Yeah, I do.
You don't seem to understand what's what.
Nope.
I am just as in the dark as you. I wonder what is going on. Why don't we go to my house and you can tell me your story? Looks like Tokomon is still unconscious. We can treat him there.
Hey, Tokomon. Baby. That's Teefs, by the way. That's Teefs right there. When he wakes up, we'll get to see that. Chumon is a Digimon, you're right, it's the rat that hangs out with,
So you were sucked in by the
Digimon. I've already forgotten the name of the poop one, the yellow poop one.
Fell into Sukumon? The dimension.
How did you remember that and I didn't?
And then your partners in the Digivice defeated Machine Draymond for me.
Hell yeah.
I see. Coincidence has been
out. Oh, I'm sure coincidence.
I owe you my thanks. Actually, this world is at a crisis point.
Oh no!
As you can see, the city we are in, Floatia, is in disarray.
That's a shame.
It's because of the Machine Draymond. It suddenly started attacking us for no reason and did a lot of damage to the city. The power of Omega is overwhelming. It appeared from nowhere. Caused massive damage and then disappeared. We were at our wit's end. I mobilize.
Yeah, compare mouse. Yeah, I think those might be the only two mice Digimon.
In order to capture the machine, Draymond.
I think they're more into like wolves and cats and people.
I could transport it to another dimension and imprison it.
Well, that went well.
The plan worked. In fact, the plan went even better than expected. Thanks to you, we were able to defeat that machine, Draymond. But that doesn't mean the danger has entirely passed.
Oh, no!
The phenomenon of a machine Draymond getting violent and then disappearing has occurred several times in many areas. It would be hard to believe that it is just one lone Mega Digimon doing all this damage.
Oh, is Digimon Survive a bit broken at the moment? That's funny.
We were able to survive this time because of your valiant efforts.
Hell yeah, keep praising me.
Unfortunately, we don't know from where and how the machine Draymond are appearing. It seems hopeless, but if we just had a clue, maybe we could do something. If
no
only
clues
we
here.
Had a clue.
Maybe.
What?
Pokemon is adorable until it opens
this
its mouth.
Pokemon was the machine Draymond? It can't be. No, but I am sensing a strange data wave coming from this Tokomon, albeit weakly.
I just got my copy of Digimon Survive before stream, so I have not been able to test it.
What should we make of this? A Tokomon living in this city digivolved into a machine?
That doesn't
Draymond.
Seem possible. I mean, I'm sure there is a Digivolution line that will take Tokomon to Machine Draymond, because... My boy, my godly web. The web of Digivolution is huge, but going from an in-training to a mega? Weird.
But why did this Tokomon digivolve into Machine Draymond? Or at least an altered form of Machine Draymond? We won't be able to figure it out with just this small amount of information from this Tokomon.
Go capture another machine Draymond.
But it looks like we finally have a chance to actually do something about this threat. We need to act.
Hell yeah, dude.
I have something to ask of you.
No.
We want to return you back to the world you came from as soon as
we don't like you, get out.
But we can't leave this city in the state it's in. To get the city back to the way it was, will you help bring back the residents that fled from the machine Draymond attacks?
This is the thing of every Digimon World game, is you have a city. The city has gone to shit and everybody has left. Go find people to come back to the city and build it. I'm not a wuss, get out of here. Yeah, fine, I'll help. That's why I'm playing the game.
I'm glad you said that. So...
Why would he? I believe Gigimon himself is a mega.
I will look into this small amount of strange data.
This is technically a city builder. We actually do end up using materials in this game to upgrade our facilities.
We'll be able to unravel the mystery.
That'll be a bit later.
Altered form. If we can detect abnormal information, we may be able to avoid further damage here. That's why I first intend to make a detection device. If I have any news, I will send you a digimail. So please check your digivice.
A digimail on your digivice.
So then.
They put digi in front of everything. It's very funny. Hey, Coromon. So yes, like Digimon World 1, this game is a lot like 1. You have a house with Gigimon, and inside it you get a bunch of items. You get them every day. Sure. I don't need this, but probably the easiest way to just show off everything in the game. There's the meat farm. Kind of on gives you meat every day. And what's so weird about growing meat in a field? Yeah, give me 10 meat. So you do need to feed 2 Digimon in this game, and that is a lot of food. Don't worry about the grass undulating, it's fine. Giant toilet, pretty big toilets. They're not as giant, but there are some pretty big toilets. Training. Ah, oh, look at all these babies. All right, do some training. Confirm what you want to do. Yep. So in this game, you actually get a fatigue bar that you can see. On the, in one, fatigue was hidden from you. In this, it is not. Our babies are up there. Gilman's always had a tiny baby form. This is, Gigimon. He's so tiny. He's a baby. That's also a toilet there, by the way. It's very easy to miss. I have to say, I did not for the longest time in my playthrough notice there is a toilet in the training hall, and you do not actually have to. Yes, the music is the same as once. Alright, meat weight goes up, mood goes up, fruit mood goes up, removes fatigue, vegetable, raises, and abilities increase in training. This is similar to one, while mushroom removes weight. Not needs just discipline, it's not satisfied hunger, great when cooked, cooking is a thing. Fish. So this is a toilet right here, so you don't have to leave training. Oh. I mean, okay. Alright, let's have a look in our menu. So we can look at our partners. You can see they are extremely baby. Yeah, this game hits me right in nostalgia for one, because it is so based on one. Then we've got attack skills. So right now we're going to put one skill on. Here is our board, like in one. Then we've got our tactics, what we can tell them to do. We can tell them to use MP, spend your MP wisely, spend the MP as little as possible. That's Pikachu right there. Kind of in the middle. History. So you can see we are in the first generation. 0 days old. Pichimon is very small, very curious, loved by everyone. Potamon is a rather subdued Digimon with 3 horns. Ugh, they're such babies. Alright, Tamer! This is the important bit right here. We have a level 2! In that level, we can get skills. There is a huge skill tree. You do, I think, get enough points to get everything, but max tamer level requires a shit ton of points. Like, one of the last trophies I got in the game level of points. Might even have been the last trophy I got in the game. So. Reverse type, yes. So, these are very important. So these are for when we get new generations, we get better stats if we put this up. So we're gonna need a lot of trainer points. There are a lot of really good skills in here. I'll get into that later when we actually have some points, because we do not have any TP right now. I spent 150 hours on this platinum, yes. We have an email. Let's go to 9 flames. Get your partner to rookie before heading out. You absolutely should do this. So I don't have any right now, but the subfolder for subquest, EX scenarios is like DLC and other stuff. Daily quest is an online thing. Field guide is a list of all Digimon. There's 231. There you go. So this gives you the whole list. And you do, I did have to get every Digimon. Actually it's 200, I think, of the 231 for a for our trophy. Alright, all that's fine. So you have 3 save files. I want a different profile because I've used all 3 save files in my original one. I don't want to delete any of them, so. Alright, with that done. So time is always passing, you can see in the top left. Alright, so you train both of them at the same time. You can train them in different things, but they get different bonuses depending on where they are. You also get things like food bonuses, stats like that, so yeah, and you also don't raise just one stat, you also raise the ones that are like adjacent in this circle. So like it says, you do strength, you'll also give it speed on the left and stamina, which is below it. So you use the right stick for your right partner, left stick for your left partner. You can see they get friend bonuses when they are in stats that are next to each other or in the same stat, but you also get rival bonus if you are in opposite stats. So you kind of always want to make sure your Digimon are training in stats that get the bonus, because the bonus, oh boy, the bonus stuff is kind of how you actually train stats. I'm never very good at until I get a bunch of bonuses. We'll see how it goes. Alright, let me see. So I already have plans. I want to be Lockmon with Kokomon, which is 50 strength, and I believe, yes, if I press that, I can see their stats. The Lockmon needs 50 strength and 130 wisdom. I want Gomamon that's 50 strength and 130 stamina, so that's actually really good. If I swap these guys over, that's actually, we are opposites, so that's, I didn't actually plan that, and that just happened. Alright. I'm bad at this. I normally save scum this. I'll maybe try to do that a bit less while streaming it, but, there's a minigame. I'm very bad at it. You want to land on one of these squares because you get bonus stats. So that's a fatigue bar at the bottom. It says 50%. It's about right. It's probably actually a little lower at 40%, but I'm not too worried about it. Unless you go really high, you're not going to impact your lifespan too much. So yeah, so we got 55 MP, 20. Ooh, nice. 20. Oh, hello. There are a lot of trophies in this game for firsts, and then a lot of completionist trophies, so. Alright, now that we've trained once. Okay, Digimon Kozuruka about 9 hours after in training. Digimon went something. Yeah, I just want to have a look at the square first. Yeah, I just want Togemon to finish explaining shit to me. Yes, so it's nowhere near as finicky as Monster Rancher, and honestly, there's a lot more leeway. I'm not gonna, like, your first generation is going to get to a certain point and then not be able to go any further. Like, you can expect even on easy to be probably 4 or 5 generations deep before you can beat the game, and that's kind of a low estimate. I feel like I did it on 3 or 4 going really hard, but you don't need to. There's the baby form of Gilmon as well. Nope. Yes! Oh, that's very good! Okay. So this can sometimes happen when you leave training after training. It happens more often at the start of the game. I'm gonna go ahead and praise them. This gets you benefits. So it's quite useful if you're training them leave. It doesn't happen every time, but it's good. So the top one, the sunglasses, is discipline. Bond is essentially friendship. With you, I believe. Digifriend, I think, is with each other. Happiness is the smiley face. I believe that's the, yes, so I believe Bond is the one to us, and Digifriend is the one between them, I think? Or maybe it's the other way around? Fuck, I think it might be the other way around. Oh man, been too long. Like, do I have a thing that tells me? So yes, the smiley face is happiness, the sunglasses are discipline. Discipline is how much they listen to you in battle. Happiness is just good for them, then, you know, it's good for them to be happy. There are a lot of Digivolution requirements that depend on happiness and discipline. Low disciplined ones don't listen to you very much. I believe high discipline also live longer. Like, happiness and discipline have an effect on lifespan. I don't generally worry too much about it. Let's have a chat with some people. Alright, yes, okay, here we go. So, Digimon Tamer Knowledge, yep, support them in battles, level go up. If you do what you're supposed to do, your level will go up, checking your Tamer level on your Digivice. So, once you get enough experience, you get a level. When you get level, you get points. You can then use these points to acquire skills. You get different amounts of points depending on the level as well. Yep, so how you gain Tamer experience is basically doing everything. Battling will get you some, you'll get Tamer experience when they eat, sleep, or go to the bathroom, and walking around. Walking around is probably the most effective way to get Tamer experience. I did a lot of walking at the end of my last playthrough. Well, at the end of my Platinum playthrough, I've played it again since. So yes, it's calculated when you return to the city. The further away you are from the city, the more points you get. Tamer skills, so we'll get a bunch of skills. Then the trees, yep, check around first. So, we will later on get the ability to reset our Tamer skill, like our Tamer points, and redo them. It's quite a bit later in the game. Not like end, but I would say at least sort of, yeah, half, three quarters. But yeah, so your Tamer level points, you get all the skills, yeah. Good lord. The amount of points you need for max level is insane. But don't hoard your TP, spend it. You want to be getting skills as much as possible. Let's have a look at the baby. Jerrymon. Oh, our baby. Alright, here we go. Oh, we can change partner names, camping materials. I'll probably explain this more when we actually go out, so we'll wait on that for a little bit. Meat cultivation. So yes, you get meat, free meat every day. Alright. Alright, yes, this is the online thing. I don't know if I can use this. I have PS Plus on my other account. Alright, this is the online stuff. We'll not be doing much fighting here yet. The rankings get very confused by me saving on different files as well. So you basically register your Digimon in Digivices. You can fight for points and then trade points for various items, various good items. I actually don't know if you need PS Plus for me online. I wasn't too sure. But the thing I really want is that. I think there's a button I can press to open the mail right away, but I don't remember what it is, so I'm just gonna have to go in here. Alright, daily quests. Okay, so this is the thing you can get every day. It rolls over at a weird time. I believe it rolls over in like midnight Japan. It's a little strange, but you get a quest every day. This is probably not very doable for us at this point in the game. But it gets you points, and then you can trade those points. It's much better than honestly doing the fighting. Sure, it's worth picking up the daily quests and seeing. Sometimes it's like get items. And that's quite easy. And some of them are just easy fights and stuff. Alright, here we go. So now Tokemon will tell us about stuff. Alright, life basics. High amazing power, you need your help, eat, sleep, use the bath on your command. Yep, you do have to Tamagotchi them. So many of our peers make them eat. You can feed them both at the same time or them individually. By the way, we'll see that when we actually get there. By the way, sleep in Digimon World 1, you could sleep anywhere. In this game, you do not want to sleep outside. You want to sleep inside a building, or we will get a tent later on, which we can sleep in if we're outside. But don't sleep outside. You don't get as much health back and fatigue back and stuff if you sleep outside. All right. Yep, more than half full. Fatigue, gonna get too fatigued, gonna get ill. Injuries are very annoying. They're kind of hard at the start of the game to deal with. Life and death. So, yes, Digimon are born with a set amount of life. Your lifespan increases when you digivolve. And decreases from doing basically anything. It has goes out when they die, the hand will be reborn. So when you're reborn, you get a portion. We can use our tamer skills to put that percentage of what they get up. It's a cute. I have a bunch of Digimon plushes from home now. Alright, so talk about generations. So, we're in Generation 1. Oh, this is talking about Digimon generations. So yeah, so start with In Training 1, then 2, then Rookie, Champion, Ultimate, and Mega. And then you can even go a level beyond Mega. I don't even know if it's called anything. It might just be Mega still. Ultra Mega. Alright, so right now these Digivolution conditions are not known to us, although I believe they are for rookies, so. But for champions and above, they're not known. In the first game, they were completely invisible. We will get the ability to see them later, so. This game, I would say, is kind of a much more accessible version of one. Yes, here we go. Might actually tell me which one's Bond and which one's Digifriends. Yep, Bond and Digifriend level. Bond is... Okay, yeah, Bond is the one between us and them. Digifriend is the one between the two of them. Got. Yep, I was correct the first time. So you want them to be friends with you and each other. Alright, mood. Yep. Alright, so mood is phase gauge, higher energy, the stronger they are. Sleeping, it turns it to normal. So mood is a thing that goes up and down. And sometimes they wake up and they're grumpy little fuckers, by the way. Just absolute shits when they wake up. There's discipline, so yes, it shows how serious they are. Don't they relate to Digivolution? Yep. So yeah, some Digivolutions require low discipline, a lot of them require high, and then we have poop. A lot of this stream is going to be me explaining the game mechanics. So if you let them shit outside the toilet enough times, they will Digivolve into a Sukumon. So poop them in the toilet. We also got a couple of porta toilets from Koromon there, which again is another accessibility thing from that. In the first game, it took a while before you could get portable toilets. In this game, they're a lot easier to get. And you can use, they're not even you can use anywhere, but you don't get, there are like friend boosts you get from letting them shit. in a toilet that you don't get with a port toilet. But if you're out in a battle and there's no toilet nearby, you give them a port potty. Your bonding shrine will be altered. Try a different option. Ah, yes. Okay, this is a lot of battle stuff. Again, I think I'll probably go over this when we actually do some battles. City used to be awesome, now it sucks, man. And yes, the babies do follow us around. They are adorable and they make noises. Oh, they're honky. Alright, so we have port potties, recovery discs. We have meat. So I believe mushrooms put their weight down. Okay, this is how you turn like partners on and off. So if I do this, I'm just feeding Maka. If I do this, I'm doing both. That's categories. Sort my items. So it's gonna both meet. I believe weight doesn't matter for rookies. You can see they're a little fatigued, but not too bad. So if we do this. Oh! Oh, eat the item.
Just a minute!
You're in trouble! So, yeah. Sometimes your other Digimon can pipe in and then increase the results of your scolding or your praising, which is very cool.
Come on, eat up!
That guy was like, you got in trouble with mom. Alright, so they're completely full. That's good. Way up by one. Alright, nice. So this is where you can sleep.
Training time!
Training time. Alright. Yes, Mocha is the one that wants wisdom. Pikachu wants stamina, and then they both want 50 strength, so we'll see how it goes. So I may have mentioned that I am aiming for certain Digimon, but I may not get them. That's because at the start of the game, you can't lock off Digivolutions, and if I meet the requirements for more than one rookie, I may not get the one I want. And it's kind of hard not to meet some of the requirements, because some of them are really low, and some of them overlap, so. Alright, let's go ahead and try this. If I fuck it up and get the lower value, that'll just be like lesson. Ah, too early. Oh, they are fatigued. Yep. Nope. They're going to their second form. That was quick. See if I can get there. Slightly bigger babies. Slightly bigger baby right there. So they're... since they're the same age, they will digivolve at basically the same time. You're kind of supposed to end up, staggering them a bit. There's reasons to stagger them. I tend not to because I just like my babies being at the same time. So they did lose a bit of fatigue for that. That's good. And the Digivolve, their stats went up a little bit. Also pretty good. Ooh, they've got the time bonus now. That's good. I am going to save.
Keep getting stronger.
Right, for this, I end up putting them both in the strength here to get the 50 points I need for that. You see, the more bonuses you have, the more bonus grids there are on this, the easier it is to get the, 25% bonus.
Keep getting stronger!
Yeah. Oh, I didn't actually know that you could force a rookie by locking all the other ones off. I think by the point that I could actually lock them off, I didn't really need to do that. I kind of, you know, you kind of often have enough stats to get whatever rookie you want anyway, but that's pretty interesting. Alright, yeah, but the wisdom and strike's a little awkward because they're far away. Yeah, it's only useful for like one, and its requirements are stupid. Alright, go ahead and do this. See their like fatigue or anything like that on this screen. If I look. Okay, so for rookies, we can actually see them here. So you can see the requirements. You see, so the thing here is key points two is how many requirements you need to get a specific Digimon. If the thing is yellow, it means you've met it. So you can see here, I need 3 for clear Agumon, you need 3 points, and there are 4 potential ones, so I actually only need 3 of the 4. Of course, as we, get, I believe from rookies to champions, Gumdramon's locked, okay. So if they're locked, I mean, they can't get them until I get to a specific point in the story, so I can never get Gumdramon, although his requirements are fucking huge, 480 speed, So you can see for Goemon, I need 50 strength and 130 stamina. You see I've already got the requirements for a couple other ones. Slotmon, I need 50 strength, 130 wisdom. The problem is 130 wisdom is also shared with that, so I need to not get 500 MP. I've already gotten Shamamons because it's just a lower version of Lotmon. And I've also got Toy Agumon. Oh Jesus. Alright, there you go. It's a bit of a crapshoot whether I will get Lotmon or not. I know the game has it isn't random, but nobody really knows how it decides which one it should be, as far as I could tell looking online. I know they figured out Digimon World 1's one. I don't know what that one is, but they did figure that one out eventually, how again, it's not random, but it's kind of esoteric. So, we'll see if I end up with a bunny. I may not end up with a bunny. If I even get the stat requirements. But, should probably end up with Goemon. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and... Before we do that, from one, I've kind of been like, sometimes your fatigue will come up over your poop, and you'll rest, and then you'll come out of rest and you'll have shat all over the floor. Don't think that's a problem in this one, but I need to eat.
Okay, gather round.
I've not needed to poop yet.
Come on, eat up.
Eat your meat. All right, full. Wait up by one. They're feeling good.
Here goes.
All right, we'll continue with this. Fuck, too early. Still don't need to poop. Alright, guys. Alright. I'm used to it having lag. Ah, there we go. Now I need to poop. I'm gonna go to the outside one. Ah, there we go. Good, good, good.
Yeah.
Praise him for that. Goes up when they poop in a toilet. Oh, I love Digimon. Oh. So, okay, Goemon is done with stamina, but I still need more wisdom and strength. Probably, do I want to give... It's a little tricky giving, of course, Goemon, anything else. Bukakamon. Don't worry about the names I give him. Alright, you can also rest in the middle if you want one of them to train and not the other. Don't know if there's much benefit to doing that. Give him a bit of speed. Fuck up everyone's requirements. Nah, I can't get up to 50 speed or I unlock other requirements. Is there any safe stat here? Feel the board. Not even MP really. Alright, I guess just more stamina. Let's do it. So Digislocks are also a source of food. We didn't really try this out.
Time to eat.
I believe they just need to put weight down in this game. So the different bonuses don't only mean is the type of bonus. They don't do anything different. But the time bonus, I believe, is based on when your Digimon like to train. Yeah, weight down by one, but it didn't fill them up. But
I'll do another one.
Friend bonus and rival bonus explain when they're in different ones. All they do, every bonus does the same thing. It puts a thing on the bonus board, which means you get the 1.25% instead of just getting your 1%. So the more bonuses you have stacked, the easier it is to get that bonus.
Stay focused. All right.
So I think Pokemon and Strength looks pretty safe for Pokemon here. So yeah, let's put them both in Strength. I should say, the stats do. HP is HP, MP is of course for moves. If you want to do any moves and if you want to do any attacks in battle, you need MP. Even your basic attacks take MP. Strength is how strong they are. Stamina, I believe, is defense. Wisdom is how smart they are. So they'll use better moves in battle if they have more wisdom. And speed is how fast they can attack in battle. All right. All right. They should now, if I look at their history, both have... Yes, they both have the requirements for the one I want. This one has requirements for two others, just by nature of being. Okay, so I should get Goemon, basically guaranteed. There is no guarantee I will get Lopmon. I'll explain some of these other conditions when we actually get to them, like Key Digi and all that sort of thing, but... Alright. Am I still on the same day? Yeah, I believe I'm still on the same day. Yeah, 890 experience. I'm about to roll over an hour. Oh! Alright, did I get Bunny or Nay? Here we go. Bunny! I got the Bunny! There's Lopmon. There's my Bune. Easy every time. There's Goemon. I love both of them. Seal acquired, hell yeah. So yes, you can see here, now they show you all the requirements for rookies in here. They do not show you the requirements for anything above Rookie. So these are four champions I can Digivolve to, and I know none of the requirements. But that's a lie, I have a guide. the guides online will show you all the requirements. There are ways to find out these requirements in the game, unlike Digimon World 1. So you can find these out using mechanics in the game. I'm pretty sure I'm going to be going for their normal upgrades, so Akakumon for Goemon and Terurimon for Byun. Alright, so now they should have proper attack skills, yes. So the one over there on the right is their special move. That's Marching Fishies, which as it should be. So yes, we now have a grid. So the ones that are lit up are the ones they can use. So Goemon cannot use poison powder, but I have learned it. So your attacks are from you, and you can use them in any Digimon. You don't have to learn them on both Digimon, which thank God. So we've only got a basic move for either of them. That's pretty alright. High tension ability takes damage from MPs of HP. Ew, gross. That's gross, actually. I hate that. Temporary wisdom increase, fair enough. Alright, so look at their stats. 122. Okay, speed abysmal, but that's life. One's a vaccine, one's a data. Alright, doing pretty good. Yeah, they both need wins. Both need low discipline. I don't know if that's happening. Which reminds one care mistake, that's a lot. Okay, so Akakumon needs to be heavy and Terurimon needs to be light. See how that goes. By the way, if you do not manage to get a rookie to have a champion's requirements by the end of 3 days, you will Digivolve into Numemon, who sucks. If you ever played Digimon World 1, Numemon was probably the Digimon you got, if you didn't know how the system worked, so. Alright, now we have rookies. Oh, yep, good shit.
Good job!
This might do it. There we go. So, things like this. Whenever you get an opportunity to, like, praise and scold them, you get some information about their Digivolutions. So, later on we'll be able to essentially buy them instead. But right now, any chance I've got to have a look, will actually tell me. So, now we know that Goemon can evolve into Seizuremon or Icemon, and Lotmon can evolve into Wizardmon or Black Gatmon. Yeah, Bunny can turn into Cat! Wizardmon did come from the moon. I believe that Wizardmon and Black Gatmon are actually fairly easy to get. Not bad. Let's see if it happens. Alright. So, yeah, those things will then slowly open up these stat requirements as well. So, like, we might learn key points for Black Gatomon next and so on. I can't remember if I can, like, zoom out my camera or not. Okay, we've not passed anything yet. Alright, well, I'm gonna save, and we're gonna try and venture out of town now that we have rookies. I don't know if we're strong enough yet. But we're going to Nine Plains. No worries about the field, this one will appear. Can I zoom out the camera? I feel like I can. So, Digimon are wandering around. You can kind of run away from them sometimes. Ah, L1 and R1, alright. But in non-fixed locations, got it. So yes, you do get in a fight as soon as... There we go, I can zoom out a bit. As soon as you exit town, so do not exit town without some rookies. I don't believe this is a particularly hard fight, but... Oh yeah, sure, that was me. Yep, mm-hmm. This is the battle theme from 1-2, I love it. Oh nice, yes. Yeah, Palmon's not very strong. But this is night, and enemies are stronger at night, by the way. I shouldn't say enemies are stronger at night. The enemies that are around in the field are stronger at night. The enemies themselves don't get stronger. They change. Alright, first fight. And first recruit. I beat you up, but it didn't really hurt. How about you? Okay, let's go back to town. No, I ain't no bad guy. I beat you up, but I ain't a bad guy, right? Alright. Well, Digimon, join the save. So like in 1, the first thing you do is go out and fight a thing and make them join the save. I'm positive there's a button. Oh, there's my map button. Alright, this game very importantly has a map. So... Yeah, pretty good, pretty good. Toilets will show up on it. I believe you have to find them, like, to uncover them first. To the right is a pretty... quick fruit, alright, I'm sure there was a button to just check your Digimail, but... Alright, there we go. Patmon, join the town. Mm-hmm. So Bottomman will tell you about where Digimon are for recruitment. Generally speaking, if we look at their map, those exclamation marks are normally Digimon to recruit. Yeah, so your Digimon will, if they see an ingredient, pop out at you. I do not want to go further up here. There's a pretty hard fight up there. I'm honestly a little wary of going out and about in the dark. As you see, there are actually Numamon around. Can I, like... So you get ingredients and materials. There we go. Sort of hoping I can, like, sneak in and get these before, without fighting that Goborimon. Digicopper and an old card. So the cards are also a really hard trophy. Bring that hands down on your partner Digimon. Place in some storage. That's a toilet over there. I think there's a Tentomon over there. Well, yeah, what are you looking at, game? Ah, okay, it's showing me the exits. Got it. Alright, stronger enemies become. So yes, the further out you venture, the stronger they become. Also at night, they're a bit stronger. Oh boy. I didn't really want to do this, but alright. Probably not too hard to fight then. Alright, use items, use attack command to flee or change target. So you press triangle to open the item box. It also stops time, which is very helpful. Oh, you can also throw items at, yeah, both partners or one partner or the other. Be careful, because sometimes you will, yeah, you'll accidentally use two items instead of one. Alright, text menu. Yeah, so you flee, you end up back at the start of the area. Which can be both useful and or annoying. Bond level. So if you're at 100 bond level, which is the max, they start with 100 order points, which is pretty useful. You get both tamer experience, stats for them, and money and items from fighting. Yes, order power is not carried over, it resets to the base value, which is the bond level. Like, something's out there. You know, gather more materials, then head home and do a bit of training. Here we go. Before I want to get it today before I come back out. The Numemon are very difficult in the starting area at the start of the game. Alright, so I believe.
Ready?
Yeah, so we can carry 25 materials. So materials in a separate, like each area of your bag has a maximum you can put in, and materials is separate from, like food is separate from like healing items, and materials are separate, which is good because in the first game it all just kind of went into one, very limited pocket. Oh, guess I can't go up and around that. Alright. Yeah, if port parties do not have autopilot. It's not that I would use it right now, but. Okay, Numemon are actually kind of surprisingly hard. I'm like trying to see if I can go near one to kind of show its level. Yeah, level. It says level 2! Oh boy. So the thing about Digimon is, it shows a level, and the number is important. Lower levels are less dangerous, but it's a level 2 champion, which means it is much stronger. Oh, hello. It is much, much stronger than a level 2 rookie is on the field. You have to pay attention to both their number level and, like, what kind of, like, generation they are. Like, a level 1 ultimate will rip your shit apart. Where, like, way more than a level 10 champion. It definitely leads to some confusion. Alright, it is time for sleep, so I think I can sleep in here. As I said, unlike one where you can sleep anywhere you want to sleep inside. A rookie can absolutely match a low level champion. If all that really matters is stats. So if I have like 1,000 in every stat, that level 2 Numemon doesn't stand a chance, even if I'm a rookie. But when you see them in the field, their number level corresponds to like their stats, but their stats based on what generation they're at. So, like, an enemy level 2 champion is almost certainly stronger than an enemy level 2 rookie. Way stronger. But you can get as strong as you want.
Over here!
Alright, babies. Go sleep.
Sleep well.
Alright, so you can see their recover, their fatigue recovered 100%, HP 50, MP 100. You can see that Mocha woke up in a fucking terrible mood. Garbage mood. They're not so angry at me because they're hongy. Alright, I don't even see their way. Oh, I know. You're very angry with me. So, I'm gonna have to feed them separately because Mocha wants to be light and Gomamon wants to be heavy. So.
Who's hungry?
She didn't even get Gomamon heavy enough. You can't feed them outside of when they're hungry, unlike, one, where you could just feed them as much food as you wanted. Okay, good. You want some meat? They're very needy babies. Let's have a look at the two of them. Wait, yeah, 14 and 10. Kind of where I want to be. You should have more items for me. Portable toilet. Autopilot, nice. Cover desk, MP desk. Alright. Not bad at all. Yeah, it's like rank kind of determines where their stats start as they scale. It can be a little annoying when you cannot tell whether a Digimon is a rookie, champion, or ultimate. I'm looking at you, Meteormon. Generally speaking, lower levels you can go after, high levels you can't, but keep an eye on, like, whether they're a rookie, champion, ultimate, or even mega. Alright, good. Item storage is here. I'm gonna put the fruit away. We're gonna want the different kinds of fruit, because I believe there's Digimon I can recruit pretty early that wants, like, a bunch of different ones. Alright, anything else I want to put away? Not right now, I don't think. Storage is helpful. I probably want to do a bit of training. Alright. Yeah, meet your mom. You'll think you're fighting a Gotsumon, and oops, it turns out it's a Meteormon, which is an ultimate level Digimon instead of a rookie, and you get your ass fucking blasted. Which is funny. Alright, so let me have a look here. Alright. So for Terrarimon, I need 300 strength, 300 wisdom, 240 speed. I need lots of wins, but that'll come from just being at the start of the game. Whereas for Gomamon, 1700 HP and MP. 500 stamina is a lot, that's probably not happening. Weight 25, mistakes less than 5, discipline low, wins. Interesting. I'd probably go for that HP and MP and then try and get around the stamina. I have 2 points already from the mistakes in the key Digimon, which is Gomamon. I only need 3 more, so I get wins, that reduces it to, like, 2. And get the weight, that reduces it to 1. There's definitely a lot of, like, looking at spreadsheet in this one. Alright. 240 speed isn't a bad idea. Speed and HP are opposites. Okay, the good thing I believe about only Mocha having the day bonus is that it doesn't matter, it puts it on the board anyway. So even if only one of them has it, I believe it's still better off for me anyway. Right. Go for HP. You can see that the bonus is on the board. Oh yeah, that's nice. Alright.
Okay, let's go!
Probably want to give Gomamon some speed. His speed is atrocious. Shit. I managed to fall directly in the hole. How's the fatigue doing? So the fatigue doesn't go up anywhere near as much when they're higher level. Ah, now I have... Oh, yes, mood bonus. When they're high mood, I get that. So I should have 4 bonuses on the board. That's pretty good. Toilet picture is amazing. You can see the more bonuses you stack up, the easier it is to get the better stats. And it does add up 25%. It does get pretty significant.
Stay focused.
Alright, this and a rest, and then I'll probably head out. I'm gonna swap them around. Definitely want some more health on Macha before I go out exploring. It's probably Mocha, isn't it? I'm not very good at pronouncing words. So much easier to get the bonus when the whole board is full. Oh, I need to get my meat. Probably feed them both meat. As long as I keep Mocha pretty low. It's below 19. Or below 19. Yep, they are fatigued. Go ahead and rest. Get my meat. The daily meat. Oh, only 5. Ouch. Alright. Let's go do a bit of exploring, shall we? See if we can't get anyone else into the village. It's definitely a slower start than 1, mostly because you have 2 of them. And in 1 you start out with a rookie, who's pretty good. Hacker fruit. Trying to get a specific one for Palmon. So you see, instead of Numamon running around, it is Gaborimon. They are easier to deal with. I think I'm gonna look at the map. Yes, so the map records material spots that you find, as well as like fishing spots, toilets. Everything you find will be recorded on your map. It's a really good map. You can even look at the different areas of the map. I don't think we can do it yet. No, it doesn't look it. But we will be able to actually look at the whole, like, different sections of the map. Like, zoom out and go to the different areas. What are you finding? I'm something. I'm not sure where. And this is a bit nebulous. Oh, well, good thing. There's a bathroom right up here. Be a little careful here. You can spawn a giant Digimon in this area. Nice, I believe it's like right over there. It can spawn. Alright, so yeah, exclamation marks are on the other side. But you can get items in this forest. You can see, oh, you can also tell by the color it is. So this Gobblemon is blue, that Numamon was red. So, if a Digimon is blue, that means your stats are on a similar level. Actually, blue probably means you're, like, much better than it. If it's red, that means you are much lower than it. It does take into account relative rank. So if you are a rookie going up against a Mega, they will almost certainly be red, even if you can actually take them. This is useful later on. You see, in this game, another useful thing is your MP goes up over time. I don't think that was in 1. The regain on MP is very useful. Alright, got some meat, that's nice. Yes, here we go. Right. That could be useful to fight. To get this, get Digivolution information. So yes, we can see we can get a Crackamon. We also get Seedramon's Discipline and Key Points. We got Black Grafamon's Weight and Wizamon's Strength requirement. I do need one of these, so I got one of those. The different colors of the points determine what, like, kind of material you get from them. Like, green is wood, blue is water, yellow is, like, ore and stuff. Ah, that's sap. So sap is a liquid, but you get it from trees. Ah, it's Tentomon. He's a recruit. So enemies are marked by red circles on your map to distinguish them from the non-enemies here. And you piqued my interest. You piqued it. Yeah. Hope I had enough money for that. Alright, so buying that, I got Tentomon in the city, and now he's gonna open a shop. Oh. Ah, so red is ore, I think. Stone. Red is stone. There we go. Can't carry any more materials. Now your material bucket is pretty short. The lads will never stop making noises, by the way. I adore it. I adore them and their noises so very much. Good, that's salty fruit. That's very, very good. That might be what I need for Palmon. We can't actually recruit Beamon yet. We need to recruit someone else who can fly, but we'll remember that. Resin's here. You can see that, you know, during the day this is a level 1 Goblimon, at night it's a level 2 Numamon. Night is generally quite scary to be out at the start of the game.
Stay calm! Nice one!
I love the way they zoom.
That's how you do it!
There's an eye on
Way to go!
Goblimon's spell.
Stay calm!
Transitioned to evening. I believe that is still these enemies, but I should definitely be careful. No problem. So Palmon can be very annoying if the game just fucking refuses to give you a salty fruit. Yep, brought all three of them. I got very lucky. I got all three of them there. I have had some times when I just cannot find that salty fruit. Really annoying. But we did get Palmon. Anyone ever wondered why Vickers and I go, this game is why. Oh, Digimon see you, they get a question mark, and they go, it doesn't take weeks. Thankfully, you can reload items when you go in and out of an area. And there is an item spot for, the salty fruit at the very start of the flames. It required going in and out of that area several times, and I saved at the start of a day, did a whole day's work, didn't find it, reloaded, tried again. It can take a bunch of reloading. It did not take multiple in-game weeks, but it did take an awful lot of time. So you can see defeated enemies do run away. They try to find the nearest exit and run towards it, and you can kind of watch them go for a very long time. They do disappear if they get out of your sight, but it's very funny if they can't get out, because they just kind of can't. It's very funny. Yes, Digimon Survive is out today. I got my copy of it. I'm looking forward to playing it. In celebration, I'm playing this game.
Got a second? Made my day.
Made his day.
Made my day.
Mm-hmm. Still a little ways from a level. Alright, so Palmon makes the field better. Gives us more meat, thank God, because I do not have much in the way of meat. Here is Tentomon. Alright, portable toilets, autopilots, recovery discs, which are HP, and MP discs, which are MP. Alright. You guys should be like a day old, right? Yeah. I do have to be careful, I do need to get them to their stat requirements. Pretty. Alright, save.
Don't hold back.
All right, mid bonus is good. All right, how are we doing? And that is all. Go on again. HP. Here, right? What are you guys doing? 14-10, right?
Now then.
Wish I had some better meat. I don't think I have anything that gives much weight. The bond between them works as the higher the friendship is, the more likely they are to help each other out in fights. It's like attacking enemies where they're attacking the other one, I believe, like guarding for them as well is something they can do. Can't remember exactly all it affects, but it's generally useful to have your Digimon like each other. Gotta find out, I'm trying to find a list of everything that, whether these increase weight or not. Gotta find a good table, I don't really know how to find a table. Yeah, fruit doesn't really do it. Yeah, it's like, some do, like, there are some things I could find that, will increase my weight a lot. Or Goemon here, but part of the game it can be quite hard to find them. Anyway, let's go with socks for you.
Let's eat!
then meet for Gobamon. Keep his weight up. Hey! I love when they get in on each other. Alright. Yep, so even this also gets you Digivolution information.
Who's hungry?
When they refuse to eat and you're like, bad boy. Firstly, his discipline needs to be low for a Kakemon, which doesn't bode well for me. Guess I could just praise him instead of holding him. Alright. None of you hungry anymore.
Are you ready?
This will be good for a Kakemon. Alright, let's... Alright, so his HP is now high enough. Don't get any bonus. The speed... The speed's almost high enough. I do instead... I guess I could just go slam into the speed as well. Soon, actually. Okay, haven't seen any of his requirements yet. Yeah, 20 plus weight for Seedramon. Not much for Mockit right now. Probably gonna need to sleep soon. Eventually do just rest anyway. I might wait until it rolls over the hour and then see if they just want to sleep.
Hey everyone!
Stop them. I'll probably do that, just make sure they don't need to poop. Nope.
Ready?
I believe it's totally fine to set up a sleep in the training hall. They like that, actually.
Sleep well.
It's in a building. It's fine. They both woke up angry.
Ready?
Lads, why so angry?
Let's eat.
Ah, meat's another favorite. Yeah, if you feed them enough, a thing becomes their favorite. And their mood goes up even more when they eat it.
Let's eat!
But they're so angry. They're supposed to like sleeping here, but they woke up pretty angry. Their mood just kind of resets, and at the start of the game, it can reset quite low. We will get things that will mean it doesn't. Alright, let's store all the weird stuff. We want to get 20 spaces, so you do want to make sure you're not carrying around too much. We're not exploring very far, so we don't have to worry too much about filling up right now, but we will later on. Alright, 8 meat. That's a much better amount of meat. Cormon, give me some free shit. Medicine, oh, that's a very, very good thing to get for free. Medicine is very hard to come by at the start of the game. If your Digimon gets ill, this heals them. You can also sell it for a lot of money. I'll keep it around for now. Alright, let's see if I can... I believe my lads are probably strong enough to venture into a slightly different area. Keep an eye on Maka's very low HP, but... I need to get some fights in. Anyway, there's a fruit spawn point, like, here, and here. So if you need a specific one, you can kind of go back and forth, but it's very tedious. Kind of annoying they have a recruitment Digimon that needs, like, one right away. Alright, I believe I want to exit to the top right here. There are a few different places we can go. Forest Path is one of the easier ones. This is a vending machine. So you can buy some stuff here for pretty dear, honestly. Alright, we do have to be careful here because I believe there are some stronger enemies near the end. I can see them. Those red Vegemon you can kind of see in the distance over there are, once again, champions and can be quite difficult. But there are a couple of Digimon to recruit here. Swing and a miss! Enemies are quite high.
Keep your eyes open. Nice hit. Keep going.
There we go. I got 20 order instead of 5 there from doing it at the end of an attack. Kakamon's HP and bonds info. The new one there is recruit. A Gourmand! And he wants 5 green Digistocks, so... quite a lot of them. By the way, you can get into fights with multiple enemies, so be aware of that if you're in an area with lots of them. If we're ganging up 2-on-1 at the moment, that will not always be the case. To sort of win this fight easier, but a lot of points. Okay, I want to use a recovery disc.
There you go. Yeah,
yeah. Oh, Gomamon is out of MP. Uh oh. So when they get that fatigue in battle, that means they're out of MP. Ooh, hunk of meat, that's probably got some weight to it. Oh, learned my jab, nice. Oh god, that's the one that has a green mushroom near it. Nothing. Oh crap. I need to poop. Yeah, so when you find a Digimon, they tend to send you a mail to remind you of what they wanted. Which is great, because it's very easy to forget. I know. Take me into Cooper. If you leave an area and come back, the enemies do respawn. Kind of hoping to sneak past. Kind of does not wanna. Nope. Finally had enough of me, Uh-oh! That's very ungood. Okay, that red Vegemon didn't want to have a go, which is...
Keep your eyes open! Way to go!
He just on you.
Here we go! Yeah!
I want to talk to this Wormmon! I ended up way too close to that red Vegemon! Nope. This is going... so good. Just say this is going absolutely wonderfully. Nope. Oh no, trophy from it. Didn't really want to fight two of them. A little too strong for me at the moment. The draw distance is way longer than I remembered it being. Look at the Fugamon all the way up there. Ah, there's Digistop. Alright, I'm gonna gather some stuff and then head back to town. Oh, got a rare one there. uses for these materials yet, but we will. So it's good to start gathering them early. I'm gonna fight some Gaborimon. I need to fight 15 things. You can see that they don't want none of me because they run away. So when you're like strong enough, enemies that don't want to have a go will start moving away from you. But you get good. More games need to do that. It always annoys me in games with overworld enemies where when they're really weak, they still chase you. Because it's like, ooh, impetus. It's really like lots of opportunities for praising. Like why is the little lad still wanting to fight me? See if it can't boost his weight.
Time to eat.
Alright, how much weight up? 3! Very, very good. Alright.
Come on, eat up!
Let's look at how we're doing. 20's good. I need to be 25. For a Kakamon. You can see HP 1700, I got that. So we're good there. So victory is another requirement. That means I need to kill 15 things. That is also a requirement for a Kakamon, so as soon as I get that on Seedramon, I know I've done it. Which is nice for me. We're still just getting loads of things for these guys. So I gotta wait for a Black Gatomon. TF is training failures or care mistakes. So we need less than 5 for Wizardmon. There are some that need, like, you to actually make mistakes. Can't remember exactly what counts as a care mistake. In the original game, it was, pooping, outside of the toilet. I find it to them.
That's how you do it!
Not feeding them when they're hungry until they stop being hungry.
That's how you do it!
Might be it. There are so many things that people thought were care mistakes, but actually weren't. Let me see if I can find what counts as a care mistake. I'm sure somebody has it somewhere. This probably has it somewhere, but... Ooh, a bandage and an MP disc, that's pretty good. Ah, there we go! I got 3 points for Tamer level 2. Alright, use it to acquire various Tamer skills! Finally, alright. Let's go through all of them. So, Treat Type is, interesting. This one... I don't like getting this one early. Despite the fact that it's like, you get Tamer experience when these things happen, and those things happen a lot, it requires you to get, I think, all of these, which is 9, and then 15. 24 points is a shit ton of investment. And the reason why I don't like it so much is there are other things I want to see. But these give you like small bonuses while you're doing these treat type things. The Digi Egg is really good to get at least one of these per generation, I would say. I'll probably wait until I'm closer to dying to pick this up, because it's not useful until you go into a new egg. So what this does is it gives you more percent stats when you get a new egg. I can't remember exactly what the percentage is, but I believe it's like fairly significant. And you do want that. I tend to try and get it one per generation of eggs, because I think going more than that is a bit much, but you do want to be increasing this. So this is lifespan. This is increased lifespan from Digivolution, and this is increased lifespan in general, and then big increased lifespan. I don't tend to get these, because at least until early on, because honestly, you kind of do want to keep going through the generations. It gets easier and easier to train your Digimon as you like cycle through your eggs, essentially. These are useful. This is, of course, item capacity, but I don't need it yet, so we'll be holding off. Trainer type. Oh boy, you want all of these eventually. If you like to get training is where you're gonna get most of your stat points early. Later on, you're getting stats from battle, but that's kind of far in the future, I would say. Early on, these are pretty good. Increased effects of training. Then we've got like boosts, boost mood when eating, boost mood when using the bathroom, boost HP, recovery from sleep, boost effects of scolding and praising, and bond and digifriend, as well as mood whenever eating, bathroom, or sleeping. Again, useful, but maybe not first. These ones are very good. So these ones are very useful because your stats go up more when you digivolve. And since you are constantly digivolving, these are just good. This one is really good at the start of the game. Of course, it gets less so at the end, but you have like 230 Digimon to choose from. You're probably choosing new Digimon each time. So this is, I think, useful for most of the game. And yeah, like, so these are good. They're 5 points each. Let's see what else we've got. Finder type, also good, but probably not the first thing we're gonna do. Discovery of ingredients. Increases fishing hit rate. When we get to fishing, I'll want this. Unfortunately, I probably won't have it. You really want, like, a higher fishing rate when you're fishing. This right here is potentially what I'm gonna get right away. Recover HP, while you're walking around the world map, your Digimon will just recover HP. This one also recover MP, very useful. One thing I haven't mentioned is Digimon gets sick. There are areas in the game that Digimon don't like being, like a fire Digimon will not like being in the ice zone and vice versa. And if they're in there too long, they get ill. This can be bad if that is the area of the game you need to be in. Most importantly, that also gets to this. Recover massive HP and MP while moving. It requires you to have all three of these. It's a lot of point investment, but it's very good. So this is like, yeah, boost quantity, and then, yeah. So at times, we'll need to get a lot of materials for city building in the future, but we can, again, kind of ignore this for now. But it is useful to keep in mind when we do start doing that. We don't have cooking yet, because we don't have camp yet. I do actually ignore cooking. Probably more than I should. It is useful, but it is something that you can live without, so I do tend to. Alright! Battle stuff. Now this is where, yeah, you're kind of always vying between things like survivor, trainer, basic, and fighting. Because all of this stuff in here is useful. So this allows them to use a second attack. So all of my Digimon have just one attack at the moment, and that will not be the case later on. Variety of attacks is, you know, good. You want like hard-hitting ones that use a lot of MP, and then like low MP hitting ones for like low stuff. You go up to 4. Then you have defend. We do not have defense yet. this is another one we can probably get fairly soon. Defense is very good. You can have your Digimon attack and then defend the enemy attack and take less damage. If you're good at timing this, it's extremely useful. It's also kind of necessary for some of the story fights. So we will want this very early. You then upgrade it and then it reduces damage by 100%. It's not actually 100, it's like 99. Rockweed, Metal, and Liquid. What's the other one? So yeah, these two in conjunction, extremely busted, almost, honestly. These are the kind of like things that allow you to punch way above your weight class. If you're very good at ordering your Digimon, it does cost order points, by the way. But if you're good at timing it, you can punch so far above your weight class with these two. Then this is like, you know, I get more order points by like supporting. And then the final one is now you can actually have more order points than 100, which is good because you can just kind of blast out your special move very early. This entire tree is very good. Drops, as always, extremely good. Increasing drop rate, who doesn't like increasing drop rate? So then you also, you increase drop rate, you increase the amount of money you get after fights, and then the last one is item drops and money. This one also very good. This one in particular, boosting post-battle parameter increase. So you can increase the amount of stats you get from training, you can also increase the amount of stats you get from fights. The learnable experience of this one is part of the reason why in late game, fighting is actually far superior to training for stat games. At this stage in the game, it's very much training is better. But yeah, getting more techniques is very good, and these two are kind of incredible. And we will, again, don't need them right away, but we will want them. You see how many things I'm like, we want this? It's too many things, there are too many good skills. So yes, cooperation boost attacks, huge boost to critical rate for attack ladder from behind. This one's awkward because you can't really control that, but... rate of attack skills that strengthen your friends, raises the rate of being granted special status or normalities. Halves the OP cost when you use a special move. This one is interesting, because you need 150 to do it. But then sometimes you want to use 75. It's a weird one. This one's good. Sometimes negates MP cost. So sometimes you can just blast out your powerful moves and you just don't even use the MP. Once again, I'm not going for these early, but these are definitely ones you want to aim for later. So area of effect. So actually, items have AoE, so if your partners are actually standing in the same space, your one thing will heal both of them. This expands that to make that more useful. This is useful because sometimes you like go, oh shit, my Digimon is dying, and it does actually take time. Like when you choose your item, it doesn't go right away. You do actually have to throw it at them. And sometimes your item doesn't reach them in time. That makes it faster, so it probably will make them in time. This one, very good. Sometimes you don't use an item when you use an item in battle. Sometimes you just don't. It's great. You keep the item and you get to use it. Very good. It raises the order power of a partner who throws a combat item. Yeah, falls about who is midair. It happens in this game. It'll happen on stream for sure. So the first. What do I want first of all? I think I'm gonna go for the HP recovery. And it's useful early on because healing items cost money. I don't have money. So we're gonna go with Health Runner. The next thing I probably get is, I probably do try to get an egg. But it'll either be training or it'll be the Digivolution. But you do require a lot of experience to level in this game. Alright. Pick up that apple. oh, there are so many skills, there are so many... I mean, the thing about this game is I don't actually think there are any bad skills on your tamer tree. I think there are ones that are more useful to get early and more useful late. The Gotsumon are scary. What does Vemon want? Pokemon first, yeah. Yeah, those guys are red. I don't want to mess with them yet. Yeah, so you go from the plains to the desert. Oh, hi. Hi. Hello. Ambushed. I say I do need to do a bunch of fights for the Digivolution.
Okay.
It's kind of a good idea to sort of wander out here and have a look, but then we actually probably want to be champions. For most of the rest of the areas out and about. World 1. If I say a name and it's not the name you see on screen, it's because they were called that in a different game. Or a show. I have to check Digimon to see if I've hit 15 yet. I don't believe I have. Digimon, or maybe even two more, to advance the story. But the story does require me to go to that server desert, by the way. It's not quite the next area to go, but it's pretty close, so, like... The game does ramp up pretty heavily, pretty quickly. Alright, let's have a look. I'm glad I've already unlocked this, because this does tell me if I have 15 victories or not. Here's a Digistar. Yeah, they like alerting you to things, which is cute. Alright, let's kill these very easy lads. Do you see that had like a blue face and was like running away? They were close enough to join the battle, but they did not want to, so they ran away.
Keep your eyes open.
I'm almost out of MP. Definitely want to go back to the town now. There he goes! I love watching them run away. There he goes. Oh. Okay. Good thing I was heading to the city then. Good timing. Alright. Let's Get your pooping. Still not at 15 yet. 20 and 6. Alright. Okay, I can almost certainly get Lotmon to 300 wisdom pretty easily. And that should be good enough for the evolution. Lotmon's a bit more of a trouble child here. Really need to get that weight up. Go ahead and save. You should save pretty often. You can find yourself getting owned pretty heavily. By the way, your Digimon can die in fights. I believe they have 3 lives each? I don't know if it shows it anywhere. And then they become an egg again.
Keep getting stronger.
Oh right, that's what the day bonus is. Every day of the week has a training that it likes. That bottom stat is fatigue, yes. I don't generally worry about that until the stat bubbles come up. I don't think you generally have to worry about it until the stat bubbles come up. Once they do come up, you do want to rest them, otherwise, I don't know if it's a care mistake. But it does lower their lifespan, and you don't really want to lower their lifespan if you can afford it. Tell them the training failures in this one. Anyone tired might be a training mistake, but there might be a tutorial somewhere that tells me what a training mistake actually is. Alright, let's go with 300. We're gonna get 300 wisdom and 1700 MP, so let's go with this. I know, he has no stamina and no health. But unfortunately, I need to get the requirements for Digivolution first. I do not want either of my lads to become Numamon. You do have a bit of leeway. I think you have to get to like day 4 or 5, but if you do not get a champion's requirements, you do end up getting the sewer monster. So, we will be working hard so that does not happen. I don't think getting Numamon is quite as big a disaster in this game as it was in 1, but it's still not
good. Keep getting
strong. They don't gain stats very well. And they're not very good, Digimon. They get a bit better when you get good poop skills. By the way, one of the tech trees is poop. I may show that once I do this training. Fine. I believe that is poop. They've stylized it so it maybe doesn't quite look like a turd, but that's the turd moves. Did learn. Oh, yeah, there's Mac Jab. Okay, less MP, a bit more power, same range, but this has a status effect on it. That's slow. Slow's a pretty good status effect. I'll probably still keep that. Make sure they don't need to poop. Nope. Alright. probably do is keep training until, keep training until they reach the stats I want, and then tomorrow morning go out and try and get those fights. That should get me up to the champion requirements. Yeah, Mocha should get 300 wisdom, which is a requirement. Pikachu is still a little ways away from the 1700 MP, but not super far, so I will probably put Mocha into some HP once it has the wisdom requirements, because 700 HP is so low. By the way, max stats in this game, in the first game it was triple nines, and then four nines for the HP and MP. It's been increased by one digit for this game, so you can go up to 9,999 in every stat and 99,999 HP and MP. So the numbers get big. The numbers right now, they are small. These numbers would actually be pretty big for Digimon World 1, but right now they are baby. Go with that.
Hey!
Time to eat.
It's actually way harder to get discipline down. But yes, if your partner really likes this, they get extra bond and bonus.
Let's eat.
All right, 21 and 6, good, 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 good. You only get 3 files, which makes me sad, but ultimately works out. All right, so I've hit 300 wisdom, which is what I need. 300 strength, which is, I mean, I guess is across the way isn't the worst, but I think I do want to get some HP on this bunny. It's so weak. Oh shit, not very good when they're spread apart like this. Almost hit 1,000. Alright, Goemon has now hit, again, I can't like see it here, but has hit the requirements for MP, which is good. I do recommend playing this game with the Digivolution guide. Oh shit, I've hit the requirements for Seizuremon. Okay, well, if I don't get Kakamon, I will get Seizuremon. Seizuremon's cool as heck. So that's not bad at all. So I do at least have guaranteed Goemon is fine. Yeah, haven't got Wizardmon. See, the key points tells you if the key points is lit up yellow, it means you've got all the requirements. You've got enough requirements to digivolve, which is nice. I really like this system. I mean, I think there's a reason why this game is like, it's got pretty much the same system as 1, but it's a lot less inscrutable. It still takes time to build up this information, but it does actually give you this information and you don't have to worry about it as much. Alright, so Rurimon, I should be 5. I should be 4 at the minute. I need 5. If we get 15 wins, that will bring me up to 5.
Keep getting stronger.
All right, let's go. Let's slam them both into some strength, I think. And my last training of the night. The reason why I like to leave to poop, even though there is a toilet in there, is because of this.
Excellent.
It requires me to leave. I don't like leaving every time, even though, like, it's more optimal. Oh, look, I finally got Terrarimon. But it does, like, give me the opportunity to go out and potentially get that bonus. Yes, they are fatigued, but they should be sleeping in 5 minutes. Should not be a problem. No.
Over here. Sleepy time.
Sleepy time. All right. So champions usually rookies digivolve into champions at around the 3. Oh no! Oh no! How you? I just took you to the toilet. Fuck.
Now.
But I took you to the loo! Damn it. Ah! Damn it! I took you to the loo for a reason! Alright.
Ready? Come on, eat up!
Man, I always try to take a little loop before that. I was like, it's fine, they literally just pooped.
Come on,
literally
eat up.
Just pooped. This is why I tend to take them by a toilet before I sleep them. You do have to poop an awful lot before you become a poopmon. Thankfully, but man. Lad, you're killing me. Okay, all good things. Do pick up your free items, especially at the start of the game. Losing a battle. Yep, but collapse. Most of them collapse. We sent back to the city. One person active, a regain disc. Maybe you can't attack. Nope, that's not what I meant to. Yeah, I know all of this. I'm trying to find out. Stacked status moralities, a skill increases. Up to 3 status moralities, you stacked at the same time. Force on call, it's first to disappear. That increases the same type of little right each other. She's an attack. While attack is raised. Like overwritten. Okay. You, I want to talk to you, actually. Okay, so yes, he's telling me about Wormmon, who I did see and was not able to, and Numemon, who was not able to recruit. I did find the Digimon spoiling for a fight. He always tells you about 3. Same as in the original game. Alright, well, that was definitely a little annoying that he pooped in his sleep. What a little shit. Alright, but now we're gonna go out and do some fighting. Yeah. You mentioned up there, you can probably see him. That's a Fugamon, which is an Ogremon recolor. It's a champion level Digimon. That guy is a fucker, don't go near him. Those are dead ends, so you don't have to go up there. Probably gonna fight some more Auroramon, try and get those green digistocks. I believe 30 is the maximum support I can get for doing a well-timed cheer. I do have to hit for that to happen.
Stay calm.
Alright, take 2. We're quite a bit stronger now. I love having them both, like, follow you. And they will continue to follow me around even when they are big. These two are two tiny little babies right now. Digimon do get big. Because the arenas are kind of set where they spawn, and that's why that one at the end spawns me near that red Vegemon who will kick my ass. Do not go anywhere near the red Vegemon, they are deadly at this point in the game. Same as in 1, the red Vegemon in 1 were also very scary. The Vegemon is a champion level Digimon. Which again is why you have to, like, some people, you know, you see the level and you're like, oh, it's only level 2, but it's red, and it's like, it's probably red because it's a champion and it's actually way strong. Pay attention to the color. If you don't know your Digimon as well as I do, to just know what Digimon is, a rookie, champion, or ultimate by looking at it, pay attention to the color. I like that it has, like, I always like the Xenoblade thing of showing you, like, colors for, like, what, like, is this something I should fight? When it's red, it's like, no. No, I've got some wood to collect. Can you wait just a second? Thanks. Oh, there's a green Digistock. I wonder how many I have now. 4! Oh, I'm 1 short. Okay.
I am.
So the fight is definitely a lot faster.
Keep your eyes open. Yeah, yeah. Stay calm. Stay calm. Way to go. Alright. Way to go.
I do think these games like this that show me that, like, I really don't care about, like, fully, a trainer or a person yelling their move over and over again. It literally does not bother me. Ooh, hunk of meat, that's good. Yes! Praise! Oh, they boosted each other, nice. That's not great. There is a toilet back in the previous area.
Way to go, that's the way.
I mean, oh god, how many? I have to see how many porta potties I got, but I mean porta potty here. Mainly so I don't have to reload the area. Digistock, that's nice. How many do I have? I have 4. Okay, I feel a bit better now. I have 4. Having 2 in an emergency is really, you should always have 2 on you for an emergency. It's Terriermon. I love so many babies. I love so many Digimon. Gomon and Lotmon are up there. I like Renamon, I like Gilmon, I like Megidramon, I like Wargreymon, I like Black Wargreymon. You got me on the list. There are a lot of Digimon I love. I'm a big Digimon fan. You got it, buddy! So, Numemon is very good to recruit for a reason. Oh! Forgot I have to fight him.
You're okay.
He is pretty pissed though.
Stay calm.
And you can tell Gomamon is a lot slower than Wolfmon. Their attack speeds are so different. Ooh, 300 money. Very nice, Gomamon. Alright, go to the city now. You provide me a very necessary service in the city, sir. Alright. So, Wormmon is over here by the terrifying... have I gotten enough, Excellent! Alright, so I have done 15 victories now. So that's good, because... Terrurimon does require 15 victories. I believe now I should be able to get Terrurimon. I have enough wisdom, speed, weight, and wins, and... See that key Digimon there? I don't know if I've unlocked it on Takamon yet. No. So key Digimon is sometimes you get a bonus for having a specific Digimon, so... Kakamon's key Digimon is Gomamon, because they're the standard one, the TV show one, they're like, this is the line, you go from Pokemon to Gomamon to Kakamon. Kakamon's key Digimon is Gomamon, so if you have a Gomamon, you just get one key point, for free. And that's the same for Terrurimon with Lotmon, so I have a key point for Terrurimon just by having a Lotmon. Which makes things easier. Probably do want to fight at least this Auroramon. I really just want to talk to Wormmon without angering the red Vegemon.
That's how you do it.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah. Stay calm. Yeah, yeah.
I do not wish to incur the wrath of the champion level Digimon guarding the exit. Of where the battle is going to put me. So close to those Vegemon.
Keep your eyes open.
Poison Rayleigh is good.
Nice one.
I'm gonna have to run immediately because that red badging one is gonna come for my ass. Alright, talk to Wormmon. My skill is thread. Ew, gross. What am I gonna do with some thread? How about fishing line? Lifeline. Alright, so we have to find Wormmon a stick. I heard you seeing me. Alright. Wormmon is also great. Wormmon is very good. So you have to talk to Wormmon and then this stick will appear and we can take that back to him. Wormmon is an adorable little shy boy in the anime, and it's he's adorable. Okay, so I do have the Digimail. The only thing about the Digimail for every side quest is you do have to look at it in order to get the notification to go away. Alright, so I think now that I've done that, we should the story will advance. Once I go back to the city, stuff should happen. Yes, those red Vegemon are to deter you from trying to get to the next area. And they do. They are very difficult. Don't fight them. So he gives us the fishing rod, so we can fish now. Mm. Alright, so I believe that Digimail is Digimon telling us to go back to town. How many... I do have two autopilots. Autopilots are so expensive, I am very loath to use them this early on in the game. They cost 800 each, and how much do I even have right now? I have 1700, that's not bad actually. Ooh, I'm really close to the tamer level, that's good. Later on we will get a source of free autopilots, which will be very, very good, but... There are regular fish, yes. You do actually fish up regular digifish. I believe they are called like digicarp and digikoi. I probably actually have a look at some of them. I believe some are put up for rewards from the online stuff. I can have a look at that. Lotmon had a moment there. Yeah, it's like an autopilot, especially if you go much further than Night Plains, is so much worth the time it spends to walk back, but they're so expensive right now that I'm not gonna use them just now.
Oh,
Digimon's feet are terrifying. Anyway.
There are other humans.
What?
From yourself.
Other humans? Gross.
If they've suddenly been thrown into this world in the same way you were, they're probably in trouble.
Oh,
considering
no.
The strange incidents with the machine Draymond, you should also go check them out. If we can exchange information, maybe we can find out why humans have been pulled into the digital
world. You're probably
world.
As clueless as I am.
And maybe we could solve
yeah, Humon, what did you want that? Too.
Like how we can send you all home.
Get you out of our digital world. We don't like you. So one of the few places I have not been is south of Nine Plains. And the reason for that is we're going there too to the story, so.
Got a second?
Alright, Wormmon has come back. He'll tell you what your partner's favorite food is. Numamon! Numamon is very useful. In Worm, he is not very useful. Yes, we're now level 3. Alright, I'm going to... go to battle, and I'm going to get myself defend. Yeah, so yeah, he will also give you emails to tell you where to go, so if you put the game down for a month and come back, it will tell you where to go, which again, more games need to do. There is a Dino Humon, you are correct, I don't think it's in this game. And if I check this... Yes! So Digi Snakehead and Digi Pararuku. I pronounced that incorrectly, but don't worry about it. Yes, I believe pretty much every fish has Digi in front of it. But they are just fish. They're just fish. I love their icon, which is fish. Oh, hello. Yes, he's the one that tells you about all that stuff online. Alright, yeah, digital fishies. Where's Numamon? Oh, they want food. Alright. So, Numamon gives you portable toilets for free every day. So good. So good. Just wonderful. Alright, I do have some hunks of meat that should get Gomamon into a Kakumon weight range. I will just give you meat. Hey!
Stop that!
Stop that!
Come on, eat up!
because you get the bonus from both praising and scolding, unlike in the first game where, like, scolding was a bit weird, like, scolding is actually just kind of good in this game. When they do bad things, unless you want low discipline, which, things get awkward. Alright, what you got? So he's, Numamon essentially saves you 150 bits a day. Yeah, 800 is a lot. Actually, I do want to buy some more healing items, I think. Let's get 10 of each. Nice and safe. Store some stuff. I was hoping to get to champions before the end of stream, but that may not happen. We shall... let's see. I believe we should meet all the requirements now. I can't see it. But I think I should have all the requirements for Kakumon, and I should have all the requirements for Tarumon, even though I don't meet the low discipline one. Alright, we're gonna go to the south of my plains, advance the story probably in after that, because it's nearly 5. I love this game. I don't want to stop playing this game. I love this game. Like, this game just, it just fills me with joy to play, honestly. A big part of that is it, like, really reminds me of 1, and I really love 1. So the 2 exits we have not been is the cableway and the power plant. We are going to the power plant. I'm keeping going this way because I'm wondering if the giant Digimon is going to spawn. I don't know if he has a requirement. He may not spawn yet. But yeah, giant Digimon can spawn. There's like specific ones in specific areas of the game. Yeah, he's angry. Here, the giant one is very funny, but he may not spawn at the start of the game. Mostly because he would murder you. I'm not gonna fight him if he does spawn. Giant Digimon are stronger than their smaller counterparts, but they are big boys, and it's very funny. That was not good aim, actually. Mocha missed, but... this game is... I mean, I really can't state how much I love Digimon World 1. I played Digimon World 1 probably more than any other game, just so many times. Okay, I was gonna say 100% it, I did not 100% it. I all but 100% it. I could not get a perfect curling score. Ruined my 100% of Digimon World 1. Anyway, but I got every Digimon, did every arena, collected and recruited everyone multiple times. I've platinumed this game, and I then played it through again. I platinumed it in 2018. It was when I actually played it in 2017. When it came out, I played it. Please don't catch me. I was visiting Vicus, for probably March, or probably the month, that we got engaged, and, I played the ever-loving crap out of this game. Didn't platinum it at the time, because the platinum is 150 hours, but I played it so much. If you get a yellow item, by the way, it's like a level up from the area. Like, it was Digi-Quartz. I skipped through it because it's a lot. But Digi-Quartz is kind of the next level of material. When you get a yellow one, it's pretty nice. Where are you going? Where are you going, buddy? The poop is so far away. I have to use port potties again, you guys? Come on.
Hey, everyone!
There's a Kawagamon here. I don't know what its recruitment is. Give a royal digi jelly, which I have not gotten, but I should pick up that quest anyway. Yeah, unfortunately, the nearest toilet is a decent walk away, so I will port a potty. And there's just always more to do. You can always raise, you can always go out fighting. Hey, Quagmon. Ongi. The forest path is where Wormmon and Numamon were, so I don't know if it was like, if it's a key item I can now find, it could be. Or if it was just like, you can find Digijelly there. We did spot a human up on the ridge. Can't carry any more material. How many can I carry right now? 35. So it goes up depending on your Digimon stamina stats. A little weird, but yeah, we can. There's a person and some Digimon. Wait, how does she get three? I'm only allowed two.
Himari, look, it's a human.
It's a human.
Oh, Rika, don't get too close.
Yeah, humans can't be trusted.
I told you, we don't know what's going on here, so we have to be careful.
Why does she have an EX belt?
But
on her short shorts.
Looks kind.
I look awesome.
Those are the most dangerous types of people. It's not normal, and probably not sincere.
Hey. Hey, I didn't say that. Oh, this nerd did.
A human?
Oh, he's got Gilmon, hell yeah.
Hey, Himari, Kota changed completely too, you know. Maybe it's okay then. Even in the presence of a beautiful girl like me, he didn't turn into a big bad wolf or anything.
I love this idiot. She's
he
great.
He looked after Pabumon and Yuramon too, after all. Kota really is a good person.
What are you talking about?
I'm a terrible person, actually. Gross.
This person is a big bad wolf. Anyway, at least tell us your name, okay?
I don't have a
Before
name.
Before you ask someone's name, isn't it polite to give your own name first?
Oh, Gilmon! I forgot about Gilmon's one!
Yukimura, you're always so formal. You said the exact same thing when we first met.
It's called
my
manners.
Goodness.
It really goes without saying.
Well, I guess I need to learn by your example. Show us how it's done.
No. Fine.
I totally
name is
forgot.
This is my partner Kota.
I'm Kota Hirose. Nice to meet you.
I know, right? You're not expecting Patrick Sykes to come out with you.
I'm Himari's partner.
I forgot.
And I am Himari Ofuchi.
Patrick Sykes is awesome, though.
I see. That's a good name.
It's a terrible name, actually. Get out of here.
I've heard that name somewhere.
No, you haven't. Leave me alone.
Kota, do you have something to eat?
Well, see, I feel like when Gilmon Digivolves, you know, like, if he becomes like a Growlmon or a Gallantmon, that's not too bad of a
voice. We don't even know how to get back to
Oh, yeah.
As soon as it comes, you know, if it came out with a War Greymon, you would be like, oh yeah, absolutely. But like, it comes out with a teeny tiny baby, it's like, that's a voice.
You can't get back to the real world even from, Flotia?
Well, if you're still here, there really must be no way back, right?
That doesn't necessarily follow,
Could the problem
but
be the
sure.
Machine Draymon attacks? This world is in trouble.
No thanks to you, Kota. But first things first.
Wait, what did he do?
What do we do about this?
Well, let's see if we can get to Flotia. We can take these Digimon too, right?
Yeah, more babies in my town. Yep, absolutely. I love to extract materials. I actually can't, I'm too full. Oh yeah, there's like oil back here. I might want to throw away some materials to get some oil. Oil is kind of rare. Give me oil. Yeah, Digi Island, Digi Later. There's Quagamons. I love that Himari's has Salamon in Yeah, she's like, hey mom, how can she get two partners? Everyone else gets one and you get two, which is very funny. Alright. I'll blast an autopilot. I have two. Yes, that's my name. Don't wear it out.
What? Didn't you hear the first time?
Nope.
You don't remember anything, Kota.
Nope.
I'm supposed to know this person or something?
Do you remember the National Digital Monsters Tournament when we were in fifth grade?
No.
Of course. We only got into the top four, but it was still one of the best moments of my life.
Top four, you say?
Me too. We both lost in the semifinals, but the person who got to the finals...
What? It was you?
Yep.
Kota was
so master.
Nervous. I don't think he'd remember you.
I'm a national Digimon tournament finalist, I guess.
Himari just got into high school, so she probably wouldn't know you either.
Anyway, where is Gigimon's house?
Yeah, only top four. Alright, I'm just gonna save in here because it's a little easier. Alright, well next time we find out what they want to talk to Digimon about. Last Digimail. Himari! It's Himari! Yeah, there's a lot of well-known voice actors in this. Yeah, unlike Cyber Sleuth, which did not get an English voice over, this did. Which is weird to me, because Cyber Sleuth was the bigger game, but, alright, well, next time we should Digivolve into Champions. They are 3 days old, we should be getting there. It's probably gonna be very soon. And then I guess we work on getting them to Ultimate. Yeah. And maybe save a city or something. Ow. I don't think it's strictly necessary to save a city. Hello, I know things. Oh, I know. Alright, well, more or less next Friday. Oh god, I'm gonna have to wait a week. Oh, I love the schedule. This was... I do really like this game. In 2 hours, we'll be back, but we haven't chosen card crimes yet. In 2 hours, we're gonna be back with some card game. Either Slay the Spire or Eternal. We have not decided. We'll figure that out. So yeah, join us at 7. Just 2 hours for more cards. And more Digimon next Friday. I'm excited. I will keep showing off this game. It's very good. I like this game a lot. Alright, we'll see you guys later. Bye, everyone!